Okay, so situation 8. The figure below shows the shear stress or shear diagram of a simply supported beam. Shear diagram of a simply supported beam. The shear are binigay dito. 17A. Sinagay lang natin yung mga data. 17, 12, negative 12. You have negative 17. So dimensions are also given. You have here 2, 2, and 4. How much is the concentrated load at point B? How much is the uniform load carried by span BC? That's what. And determine the maximum moment in the beam. So simply supported beam daw yung ating kinukonsider. I mean sa figure natin. Yung given is the shear diagram of a simply supported beam. So, okay, parang baliktad. May shear diagram. Kukunin natin yung load diagram doon sa beam. Yung actual loadings. Okay? So, if that is a simply supported beam, considering here at point A, this is your point A, point B, point C, and point D. At point A, from zero, okay, umakyat ka ng 70. Yan. So, that is the reaction at point A. Yung pag-akyat natin from 0 to that 17, that is the reaction. Ito yan. Pa-akyat ka ng 17. Okay, then observe dito sa shear diagram, constant 17, constant, therefore, walang load in between from point A to point B. Wala pa siyang load. Then biglang bumaba to 12, from 17 to 12. Yung nag-cause ng pagbaba niyan is the load at point B. That is the concentrated load. So, gagawin natin at point B, ito yung shear sa point B, from 17, starting from 17, minus load B, concentrated load, equals to 12. Ganun siya. So, therefore, the concentrated load at B, it is 5 kN. So, galing lang dito sa point na yan. Okay, then how much, yan yung answer sa number 22, 5 kilonewtons. How much is the uniform load carried by the span BC? So this is your span BC. Now, since the shear diagram here is constantly changing or straight line, or we can say it is first degree straight line, then, therefore, there is a uniformly distributed load in between span BC. Yan yung titingnan natin. First degree, dito 0 degree, and that would be the uniformly distributed load. Mangyayari yung concentrated load basta straight yung ating shear diagram. Meron siyang straight or abrupt change in shear. Okay? So, from point B, alright, tingnan nyo. Ito yung magiging uniform load natin. From point B to point C, from B to C, you have initially starting na tayo dito sa 12, then bababa tayo ng area ng load. The area of the load is W times 4. Then that will give us equal to negative 12. Equals to negative 12. So kuha natin yung uniform load dito sa ating beam. 6 kN per meter span BC. So letter A. Then determine the maximum moment in the beam. So by the way, ikumpleto na lang natin yung load diagram dito. Starting from point from point C, you have negative 12, then bababa ito. Okay, bababa abrupt. That is because of a concentrated load present at point C. Okay, pababa siya ng amount na negative 12. Kinan nyo at point C, from negative 12. Then, bababa ng amount PC, then equal to negative 17. So, you have PC. Equal yung PC and PB. Symmetrical yan. Kasi symmetrical yung diagram natin. Puro positive, ito naman negative. Alright. Then, after that, etong from here, from negative 17, umakyat ka to point D naging 0, actually that would be the reaction at P, point D. So from negative 17, aakyat ng reaction at D. So again, basta straight vertical, that is indicating a concentrated load in the actual beam diagram. From negative 17 plus the reaction at B equals 0. Kuha natin yung reaction at B, 17. Anyway, hindi naman yung tinatanong pero kinumpleto na lang natin. Determine the maximum moment in the beam. By observation, the maximum moment in the beam will be obviously at the center. Dito na yan. Kasi ito, positive area. Equal area to, positive and negative. No, pwede mong i-cut dito, pwede natin i-cut dito, then kuhanin na lang natin yung ating tawag dito, yung moment at the center. Pwede ganyan. So, ito yung shear, you have here the moment. Pwede rin i-plot natin using the diagram. So, let's say this rectangle is area 1. Ito, area 2, triangle. Area 3, and this is area 4. Again, observe that itong nasa ilalim, yung negative area, are just equals to the absolute values of area 1 and area 2. Area 1 is area 4. Area 2 is area 3, absolute values. Okay? And this one here, alright, that one here is half ng 4. Because again nga, symmetry. Pwede mong idaan dito. Halimbawa, from B to point E. Yung shear from B is 12. Okay, dito tayo, 12. And then, bababa ng amount of the uniform load. So, minus the uniform load 6 times x. This is x. Then, the shear at point E, the shear at point E is 0. So, x is just half of 4 meters. 2 meters talaga yan. Pinakita lang natin by equation, but it is very obvious na 12 yan, then 12 din to, then nasa gitna yan dapat. Alright, so x is 2. Of course, the same din dito, x is 2. So, kunin ko yung area 1. Kumpletuhin na lang natin. Area 1 is the rectangle. 17 times 2. Ito yung 17 ha, yan yung height niya. 17 times 2. Magiging kilonewton meter, magiging moment yan. Sa kilonewton, then meter yung width, kilonewton meter. Area 2. Area 2. It is area of the triangle. So, 1 half of 2 by 12. That is 12. 2 by 12. 12 kilonewton meter. Area 3. Again, area 3 is a negative area. And that is equal to the negative area 2. Okay? The same value kay area 2, pero negative lang siya kasi nasa baba siya. Negative area nga lang. And area 4 is equal to area 1, pero negative siya kasi nasa baba. Alright, negative 34. So, kung i-plot natin lahat ng moment dito, kumpletuhin na lang natin. Starting from point A, it is 0. So, yung change in area from A to point B is the area 1. I mean, the change in moment. So, that would be the area 1. Area 1 is 34. So, the area between A and B, tinutukoy dyan, and that is area 1. So, since it is 0 degree, completely horizontal, then the moment diagram would be first degree. Straight line yan, linearly changing. So that is your moment at B. Next, isunod natin yung moment at A kasi nag-zero yung shear dyan. The moment at E. So, moment at E, starting from moment B, start ka sa moment B, plus the change in moment is the area in the shear diagram. And that will be area 2. So, 34 plus area 2 na 12. You will have 34. Okay? Ano? Sorry. 34 yung ating moment P. Ito yan. Plus area 2. Area 2 is 12. So you have 46. Yan yung magiging sagot. Andito niyan sa point A. And since it is first degree, then the curve here is second degree. Alright, that's the peak of the moment diagram, moment at point A. Kumpletuhin na lang natin. The next significant point is at point C. The moment at point C, mag-start tayo sa ME, and then plus area 3. Plus area 3. Starting from E plus the change in moment is the area under the shear diagram. So the moment E is 46, area 3 is negative 12. Bababa tayo. Naging 34. From point E to point C, naging 34. And it is linearly changing. So it is a second degree curve. Okay, observe dito. At point E, yung slope is 0. Kasi yung slope sa moment diagram is the shear, is the value of the shear at that point. So if the shear at point is 0, then the slope here is 0, horizontal. If the shear here is 12, then merong slope dito. May slope dyan na 12. Kaya ganito yung itsura ng ating diagram. Okay? Hindi siya pa ganito. Hindi siya pa ganyan. So, ito yung slope dito. Ito yung slope. Connect by curve. Ganito dapat. Hindi siya pa ganyan. Alright. Ganon din dito. Zero. Then, the slope is negative. Negative slope is downward. Left to right, downward. So, ganito yung pag-plot natin. Anyway, moment at scene. For example, di naman kailangan yung curvature. So, for example, pero sa college, kailangan siya. Okay, from MC, the moment at D from MC plus the change in moment is the area from C to D plus area 4. So if MC is 34, area 4 is negative 34, then therefore babalik yan to 0. That is your complete moment diagram. And this is your maximum. That is your maximum. Klaro-klaro naman, nasa gitna yan kasi symmetrical yung load diagram natin. Or pwede rin, kahit, again, sa board exam, hindi naman tinatanong yung diagram. Hindi naman kailangan talaga. Kung alam mo na yung magiging load condition, halimbawa dito, pwede ko namang i-cut na lang dito. Yan, kinat ko dito sa gitna, ha? May shear, but the shear is 0 at sa gitna, at point E. Klaro yan dito, 0 yung shear. But there is a moment. And that is your moment at point E. Yan ay yung maximum. Kasi again, based on observation, it is symmetrical. Nasa gitna dapat yung maximum. Then, i-define na lang natin dito. Kuha na natin yung mga values na yan eh. You have here 17 times 4, positive bending, bending upward. Hindi positive clockwise ha, negative counterclockwise. It is positive bending kasi it is bending upward. So, titingnan natin sa left side. While 5 kilonewtons will bend downward. Yung point O, ibe-bend niya downward. So that is a negative bending. And yung 6, gagawin siyang resultant, it is bending downward. Minus 6 times 2. By the way, 2 kasi kalahati yan ng 4. 6 times 2. Resulting force pa yan. Then moment arm niyan is 1. Moment arm nito is 1. So that is your bending moment at point E. That is the maximum bending